Good morning all of you, those who are there. Warm welcome, a very good morning. And yes, I'm happy to see you all coming. Thank you for joining in today. Good morning. Yes, good morning, Mona. A very good morning. Yes, so we are here on this demo call today to talk about Reiki. I hope you all must be having an idea of what is Reiki, or at least would have heard about this healing modality, Reiki. So I'm here today to talk about Reiki. So first, to be clear about what is Reiki, I would tell you that Reiki is a spiritual modality. It is a pure energy healing modality, which you get it from the universe, which you tap into the universe and you transfer it to yourself and others for different purposes. One is for healing. Reiki is used for healing. Reiki is used for cleansing, for protection of people, of non-living things like your house, vehicles, even any other non-living objects. Then it is also used for the manifestation, for your desires, for your goals. What goals you have set, you can give Reiki to that. So Reiki is used for a number of purposes. You can program Reiki for your future events, for your past events, which are there in your life, which are acting as blockages for you. So Reiki is used in a number of ways. It is a universal energy which you tap into your body. Our body is made up of energy, as everybody knows. Every cell in our body is made up of energy. This is called a life force energy, okay? And Reiki is a universal energy. So when you say Reiki, there are two terms coming in Reiki. One is Re and one is Ki. Ki is that energy which is in our bodies, which is running, flowing in our body. Re is the energy present in the universe. So Reiki, in when you combine the whole term, it is called the universal life force energy. Reiki is also termed as, or called in different ways. It is a spiritually guided energy. It is your infinite consciousness energy. So there are different terms which is used for Reiki. And Reiki is very divine and very, very simple to learn. You can apply Reiki in many number of ways. You can use Reiki in a very creative way, and you can, you know, enjoy with Reiki. Reiki can be used for each and any purpose of your life. It works on your physical level, on your mental level, on your emotional level. So on all the three levels, it works effectively. There are different levels in Reiki. That is level one, level two, the practitioner levels. Level three, from level three, the master level starts. Level four is also a master level. Level five is a grandmaster level. So as you learn each level of Reiki, your power of Reiki, also your connection with Reiki, increases with each level. You begin to develop a good connection, and your experiences of Reiki becomes, you know, a main foundation for your healing, for your life energies. Is there any other question coming up in your mind right now, listeners? Because I'm speaking, I don't know whether I'm connecting with you all. Do you have any question in your mind coming up? Please, I don't know, you just say. Does it need to be done personally? Okay, from Jaya. Personally, in the sense, the Reiki level one. So let me explain on the Reiki. As I said, there are five levels of Reiki. So Reiki level one is basically hands-on healing, where you have to be personally present for the person, and you have to use your hands. It is through the hands that you channel Reiki energy from the universe. You are mere channels of Reiki energy. Remember that. It's not, you are not using your own energy. It is the energy of the universe, what you're using as a channel, and you're transferring that energy to the other person. So Reiki level one is basically hands-on healing. With the hands only you can do. Reiki level two, when you come to Reiki level two, you're using symbols. And there where it is that you have distant healing. You don't need to be present personally over there. So that goes only for the Reiki level one. Yes. May I come on and ask, please? Yes, Neelu. Should I, Shilpa, can you
unmute? I'm just unmuting Neelu right away.
Yes.
Hi, hi, morning, Arpita.
Hi, very good morning.
Hi, morning, Shilpa. Hi, morning, everyone. Arpita, I had two questions about both the levels and the attunements.
Okay.
So if I could just ask both together. One yeah. is that, what about somebody who's already done level one and level two and is now taking it with you as a refresher, kind of, because the gap's been so long. Would the attunement be done again, or just the refresher happen? Because as you mentioned, once you're open, you're open.
I would be attuning again. Once in Reiki, the main thing is about Reiki, once you're open, you're an open channel for a lifetime. Once you receive any attunement from anybody, you're open channel. But yes, when you're connecting with any other different master, so there should be a connection, and there should be a matching of frequencies between your master also. So the master attunes you again. And there is the more attunements you take, actually the more it is good for you, because your level increases in that way. So of course, I'll be attuning the person again. Yes.
Oh, okay, super, thank you. I just wanted to really check in on that was my basic query about whether attunement happens again or someone repeating.
You can take a number of attunements for the whole lifetime, that is not an issue. But of course, once you're attuned, that is also a different point, yeah.
Right, awesome, superb. And that's basically the question I had. And of course, I do have some queries about when and if there are second dates about the workshop that have been finalized, but I'll come back to that later. I'm sure lots of people have a lot more questions right now.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you for taking me on.
Thank you, Neelu. Thanks.
Thank you. Yeah.
Arpita, I'm going to do is I'll just read the questions from the chat so that you don't get disturbed. Maybe in a while we can ask people to raise their hands if they have any question. Do you mind if people come on and ask in their questions like Neelu just did?
Yeah, of course. I think that would be better so that I could, I could connect with them much
Great.
Better.
So let us just first quickly cover the questions which are on the chat right now. There are a few.
Yes.
So Reshmi is asking, does Reiki clears away negative energies and financial blockages?
Yes, 100% it clears away all your negative energies. In fact, Reiki itself is a positive energy because it is so divine and so spiritual. So what first thing it does is it does a cleansing thing. Okay, so it clears away the negativity. And once the negative energies are clear, what happens? The positive things can be filled in. So before, of course, if you have to even remove the financial blockages, if you're talking about it, Reiki does help because it brings positivity in your life, which helps to clear the blockages, the emotional blockages, the physical blockages, and then it restores that balance, that peace, that harmony in your life.
Wonderful. Arpita Shreesh is asking, can a newcomer understand Reiki?
Of course.
And he's also asking, for a layman who doesn't know much about it, what are your suggestions?
Once you enroll for this Reiki, you know, it will be so easy. It is not anything that is so tough to understand, or you need to be very spiritual in nature to learn about Reiki. It is Reiki that anybody can learn. Even I think my daughter learned when she was 10 years old. So even when a small child can learn, it is, of course, our thinking levels are much higher, and we can grasp the things very easily.
Superb. Akrita Vidya is asking, if you have done levels 1 and 2 long back, practicing it now and then, can one jump into level 3 directly with another master?
You can do that. If you have been practicing level 1 and level 2, there is no issue. You can go for level 3 directly also.
Great. Akita Swati is asking, are you talking about Usai Reiki?
Sorry?
Swati is asking, are you talking about Usai Reiki? U-S-A-I?
Yes, Usai Reiki. Yes.
Okay, great.
Yes, I'm talking about Usai Reiki, the traditional Reiki system.
Okay, great. Arpita Jaya has a couple of questions. Yeah. I'm just going to unmute her if you don't mind.
Yeah, of course.
Okay.
Hi Arpita, good morning. Thanks for giving me an opportunity to ask you questions. First question is, you mentioned that the first stage is something where you need to be physically in front of the person while doing it, while doing the session. My question is, even for teaching, we need to be physically in front of you when you'll teach us, or is it okay, you will be able to teach us on Zoom? Because for treatment, it is personally, so I'm a little confused on that.
No. Teaching is different, and when you're giving a session, healing session is different. So when you're teaching, of course, I'll be online also. I'll be giving one class of online where I'll be explaining all the Reiki knowledge to you all, the Reiki from the beginning, from the start to the beginning of Reiki level 1. And then I'll be even on WhatsApp for 3 days with you all to give you all the different notes through visuals, through audios and everything. But the first class itself will be an online class where I'll be explaining in detail everything. And believe me, I have done only WhatsApp classes also without online classes. So it works very well, very well. And no doubt, of course, you can connect with me anytime and if you have any doubts. So there's not a question that you cannot learn. You can learn online in a very easy way at your own convenience.
Okay. Second question is, Arpita, see, lot of energies or healing techniques, I know, saps the healer. It drains the healer. And I'm not sure how does Reiki work. Suppose I'm doing Reiki on somebody else. Okay, when I'm doing on myself, there is not an issue. But if I'm doing on somebody else, will it sap my energy? And, you know, are there some precautions which you'd also teach, or how is it?
See, first thing, Reiki doesn't sap the energy. My experiences also, and what I've heard from my students also, you know, when you are giving Reiki to a person, to a different person, what happens that the Reiki passes to you. You are a channel of Reiki, right? So Reiki passes through you. So what happens that whatever healing is required for you also, it heals that and it passes through the other to the other person. So your energy never gets depleted. Instead, you are filled with the energy levels. And of course, if you're asking about some precautions to be taken, of course, the protection and the shielding part will also be taken care of in the Reiki first level itself. So that is one other precaution to be taken. But Reiki never sap your energy. In fact, it will increase, it will boost your energy if you're giving healing to any other person. Just a few days back, I had a mild headache, but I had to give Reiki to somebody who was in a hospital in ICU fighting against corona. So what I did, I started giving Reiki, and in fact, after 10-15 minutes, my headache also, you know, vanished just like that. So it was this point I'm bringing it because it was a recent example. So I could just recall that, and I hope you've got that, how it works.
Yeah, I have one last question. Sorry, because I need to be a little clear. A few days back, my mom was bitten by a dog. Okay, when she went to feed them, and she lost a lot of blood. In fact, three teeth of the dog went into my mom. She's aged. She's 73, and it went into her thigh, and she lost a lot of blood. Of course, she took injections, but the pain is still there. So my question is, when such an incident happens, does Reiki give immediate relief, or will it take time? I mean, how does the whole process work? It gives immediate results, or it takes a time, you know, to see results, specifically in this kind of a case?
Yeah, so in this kind of a case, of course, it will give immediate result because you're working on the pain directly. So it will give you immediate result, say within some minutes only. It will give you 100%, it will give you results. But if you're working on your any part of the diseases which are, which has its roots since long, that takes a little time, but it works very effectively on that. But if you're asking about any pain, suppose you have hit somebody or just as your mother, you said, of course, it will give you, it will relieve the pain. That's the main thing of Reiki, is that it helps in it aids in the pain management. It helps to reduce the pain within few minutes.
Thank you so much for answering my questions patiently, Arpita. Thank you.
Thank you for bringing up such questions. Yes, Shilpa, any other questions?
Am I audible?
Yeah, yes.
Okay, ma'am. The query is like when you get to know like one of your cousins or somebody in your relation is not keeping too well.
Yeah.
And like you're a beginner and you just want to send healings to them. Is it quite necessary to specifically pick up the phone and ask them for permission? Or, I can just assume asking to their soul and then start the healing. Is that all right?
That is absolutely all right. You don't need to ask. Sometimes you just need to say, okay, I'll give you Reiki. You know, if you feel that when you ask, they're going to say that no or something negative. So you can just say them that I'm going to give Reiki. So just relax and you can start giving Reiki. At your own convenience, you can start giving Reiki. Sometimes it's not necessary for a person to, you don't have to say a person that this time I'll be giving you Reiki. So please lie down that time. Be careful. No. You just pass on the Reiki. It will reach it. It will reach that concerned person. So in certain cases, you don't need permission. But you have to say them that I'm passing this Reiki for your good. So that's all. You don't need to take that permission of a yes, of a confirmed yes from them.
But they need to be informed about it.
Yes, just let them be informed that you are giving them Reiki.
And secondly, sometimes it is said that we can take the permission through their soul that please allow me and then we can send Reiki. Is that also possible? Because they aren't speaking physically, practically to us.
Yes, of course. Of course it is possible. But when you're asking that permission, sometimes at times it happens that you receive a no also from their soul. So you should be very clear and alert. Sometimes when you receive a no, then don't give. But if you see, I'll tell you one of my example when one of my friend, her mother was in hospital, was in a serious condition. She was aged and she had multiple problems. So, and she was in ICU also. So my friend asked me to give her Reiki. So of course, she gave me the permission because it was her mother. But the moment I started Reiki also, and when I asked her soul that I'm giving you Reiki, so I felt that she was telling me, please don't give me Reiki. Please don't give me Reiki. Okay, so I got that message from her saying that she doesn't want to receive Reiki. So it happens in that circumstances. And what happened, she didn't want to get Reiki. So I couldn't give her Reiki. So it happens in very rare cases. It happens. I'm telling you this because when you're taking a permission from a soul, you have also to be careful that it is not always a positive answer you get from a soul. that person might be in such a condition that that person might be want to leave this world also. So you cannot, the divine timing is not right for you to give Reiki. So don't, be careful when you're asking from a higher soul also, from your higher consciousness. See that what answer you're getting. Usually it is a yes, of course, but out of the 100 cases, one case happened that it is a no. So I'm just telling you so that you get this knowledge also.
Explained, ma'am. In that case, it is assumed that we also should be, I wouldn't compare it to you, but then we should be in so much practice that we should get to understand what the answer is. In case we are beginners and we don't understand that language, so it's better we practically ask them and then move forward.
Once you start Reiki, believe me, you will get answers. It is just like when you pray to God, your inner conscious tells you something. Don't think that the soul is telling you, but just if you think what your instinct is telling you, it's so as easy as that. The moment you're attuned to Reiki, you receive those energies, divine energies, it flows through you in every way. So you don't need to be so alert also, not necessary, just like you have to don't focus that whether the answer is coming yes or the answer is coming no. It will give you automatically a feeling of a yes or a no. And I'm saying you again and again that it's mostly a yes, it should be a yes, but out of the 100 cases it happens that one can be a no. So don't worry about that, whether you have to be on that level to receive such kind of this messages from the universe, and nothing like that. Just when you start Reiki, within a few days you will understand. It is very simple, very simple.
Great. And the next thing is generally once we start practicing, we become happy that you feel those energies working. Sometimes when you're discussing it out with your friend, or even otherwise, when you mention about certain things.
Yeah.
Sometimes it has been felt that you seem to have lost that kind of the vibration or that kind of feelings that you were sharing. Yes. As generally said, when you discuss something, like you see certain numbers or something, and then suddenly it disappears from your life. I don't know why. So is there any kind of is there any caution that we need to take while speaking or sharing with so that, you at least have that what you have earned and don't lose it. I don't know how to put it, but I hope I'm making some sense there.
From what I've understood, I feel that if you're talking about something that is what you have and you how to retain it, if you're asking.
Exactly.
Yes. Okay. So, basically, this is all on your thought process. Also, it depends on what you are presently in your life, what you're thinking about your thoughts, which affects your energy levels. Okay. So, if your energy, the life force energy inside you is flowing freely, you're always a very happy person. You're a balanced person. You're very peaceful inside from within. But when this energy gets this flow somewhat gets disrupted, or for some reasons the energy becomes low in you, then your thought process, then you start thinking a bit of negative also. And so what happens that time that you start thinking that you're losing certain things in life? It is never that you lose the positive things in life. I feel it only takes a back front. When your life is under certain situations of negative emotions. But again, it comes in the forefront when you're again positive. So Reiki, what Reiki does, regular practice of Reiki, always keep this positive feelings in the forefront rather than the back.
Right. Just last thing, like after the 21 days practice, once we are, we reach that level and we move forward, is it again necessary to keep doing it on daily basis? And if yes, for how long? Or is there, some kind of a short process after that?
No, after the 21 days is a compulsory one. But after this 21 days, there is not a mandatory anything to do this practice or your regular practice. But of course, if you're doing a regular practice, it's of course very good. In fact, very good. But the compulsion is only for the 21 days, not after that. And then even after 21 days, if you want to continue Reiki, you can give Reiki as in when you feel that with chakra, you need more energy. If you're feeling a bit emotional, you can give on your heart chakra, or you can work on all your 7 chakras only also. Whenever you feel, work on the upper chakras, and that is also fine. Work on your root chakra, only your root chakra. It depends then on what call you want, how you want to heal yourself. So after the 21 days also, you get a feeling, you will understand where Reiki energy is going more, which chakra is absorbing more, and which organ of your body is absorbing more energy. So after this 21 days, it's up to you where and how you want to give the energy. But always you can work on the 7 chakras, because these are the main body functions, the chakras which perform the main body function. So you can always work on the 7 chakras at least daily.
I personally thank you so very much. You've been so polite, so nice, and so easy. Thank you so very much. Thanks a lot. And I thank the team for giving me this opportunity to speak to you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. Thank you. So I got a question from Rumi, I think. Yeah. Rumi, if you're listening, yes. You can practice Reiki. You can combine Reiki with other healing modalities. In fact, it will work wonders. It will work more wonders. You can combine this with, I think you said Merlin Trinity. Yes, of course you can combine. You can combine Reiki with angels. You can combine Reiki with crystals. You can combine Reiki with any other healing modality which you are practicing. It will work wonders, because what Reiki does, it passes more of positive energy. So it is a wonderful way instead to use. And it's very, as I told you, Reiki is very creative. Thank you, Rumi.
Thank you, Arpita. Yes. Arpita, Rizvana is asking,
yes,
if only level one will help her for using on ourselves.
If only level one?
Can we use only level one on ourselves? Like, is it enough to do just level one?
What I'm saying is Reiki level one, you can use, of course, for yourself and for others. It gives you the benefits. But I would recommend the second level, where the major, hidden secrets are there, where you can use Reiki in a number of ways. So why you're sticking only to level one, I would say explore more of Reiki. Go for level two. Level one and level two, because level two contains many more things with which you can work, your problems with Reiki. So explore more of energy, if I should say. Go for Reiki level two, level one and level two at least.
Sure. Thanks, Arpita. You're being very amazing.
Yeah, thank you.
Reshmi has raised her hand. Let me just unmute her.
Okay.
Hello.
Rashmi's here.
Yeah. Hi, Rashmi.
Hi, how are you?
Yeah, I'm good. Doing good. Amazing.
I just have one question. How does Reiki heal someone who is healing from a far distance? Because you've told that for healing, the person has to be there in the front of you.
Yes. No. But, yeah. Continue.
So in the level two, you told that people, even if it is far, you will be able to heal the person who is staying up very far. So how does that happen?
Okay. See, this I would connect even to the first question. As Reiki level one, it is hands-on healing. Reiki level two is you get to learn the symbols. Okay. These symbols helps you to connect to a person who is distant. So Reiki works, and always remember, Reiki works beyond time and space. Beyond time and space, that's the main advantage of learning Reiki level 2. So that is why I say learn Reiki level 2 to explore more of Reiki energy, what Reiki energy can do wonders. Reiki level 2, mm-hmm. you will learn to work people, to work on people distantly, because it is through symbols what you're working, and that symbols connect you to that person. Those symbols, act like a bridge, a connecting bridge to that person, wherever that person is, whichever person is. So it works distantly in that way. I hope I've answered your question.
No, I want to know one more thing. But what is the accuracy, or what is the thing, if a person is staying, being there in front of you, how is that energy pass, and how is it a person who is far away? What is the percentage of level of how it gets cured if a person is staying in front or if it is far away? If both are the same, or is it more of the person is staying in front of you?
No, it doesn't work in that way. Reiki never works in that way. Reiki is very wise and intelligent energy. So what it does is your intention is a main thing, what works in Reiki energy. When you learn Reiki, the first thing I'll be telling you is that what kind of intention you're holding. If you're holding a strong intention to pass the energy, if that person is physically present or distantly, the Reiki energies work the same way, because it only depends on your intention. You should have a strong intention to heal that person. That's all, and Reiki will flow accordingly. Reiki will work on that person, whether he is in distant place or whether he's physically present.
And does Reiki solve? Does it is for the lifelong, or is it for that time it is solved?
No, it will be solved for a lifelong. But see, there are certain situations. Which I should say that if your thought process, if you have a very negative or a thought process of or your situations again appear in your life, which takes you back, of course, then you might face some similar situations. But I don't think so. If Reiki is solving a problem, it will solve for a lifetime, nothing like that. But you have to be very careful about how you are in your life. It doesn't mean that it's just like you're asking, if I now take a diet, this thing, I'll reduce my weight, but will my weight be the same the whole life? No, it depends on how, what your lifestyle is also. So,
you clear the negative energies. If you're healing a negative thing, so that means that negative should not come back to that person again.
It won't come back unless you allow it. That's the main difference. Unless it won't, Reiki never brings back the negative energies. It cleanses the negative energies 100%. But then you are a channel, if you bring those negative energies back, then again you'll have to work with Reiki. So that's a frank answer, what I'm telling you.
Have something like how that, and you teach how that negative energy should not come to you. You teach that also?
Yes, of course. As I told you, as you go in each level, as you progress in each level, you will understand in a better way how you can use Reiki in your daily life. So that is one thing. Just as we say, when you pray to an energy or to any God, it helps you a lot. Okay. So it is that energy which is keeping you holding and connecting, right? So that is what is Reiki is doing to you. So yes, as you learn and each level, as you progress in each level, you will automatically get an idea of how not to bring back those negative energies also. So, yes, I hope now I've answered your question.
Yes, thank you. Thank you very much. You have really cleared a lot of the doubts.
Okay, thank you. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Arpita.
Yes, thank
Arpita
you.
Arpita Swati has raised her hand. I hope we can take more questions.
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, I'm just unmuting Swati.
Okay.
Hi, Arpita.
Yeah, hi, Swati.
Yeah, very good morning. Actually, main 10-10 saal se spiritual practices mein hu, और मेरा सेकंड लेवल का रेकी होके शायद 7-8 साल हो गए हैं. बीच में मैं बहुत प्रैक्टिस करती थी और मेरे से एक गलती ऐसा नहीं लेकिन हो गया कि मैंने एक क्रिमिनल आदमी को रेकी दिया था अननोइंग. उसके बाद 6-7 महीना ठीक था लेकिन अभी जब मैं प्रैक्टिस करती हूँ रेकी की या स्टार्ट करने की कोशिश करती हूँ तो पूरा ब्लैक ये रहता है और कोई भी एनर्जी फ्लो का सेंसेशन नहीं रहता है. आई एम डूइंग सो मच क्लींजिंग एंड ऑल दैट. क्या रीजन होगा इसके पीछे?
सी देयर कैन बी रीजंस प्रेजेंट इन योर लाइफ आल्सो फॉर दिस ब्लैक एनर्जीज व्हिच यू आर सीइंग. Might be they are telling you something to look into yourself, to look into your life, to clear and cleanse those energies.
Okay.
So try to understand the messages. Actually, if you have been practicing Reiki level 2, as you said, I think you can connect very easily with Reiki to cleanse those energies. If you're seeing those black energies, use Reiki level 2 to clear that first.
Okay.
Practice that Reiki level 2 to clear the negative energies. I'm sure it will be cleared. It just takes a few days also. I think you will get back. If you have been practicing also, it would take just some sessions for you to clear those negative energies. And then you see what you are experiencing when you're healing.
Okay. Okay. Aur ek question hai mera. Third and fourth level jo hai, wo ek saath le sakte hai kya?
Third and fourth, why we keep a level between all these, why we keep a gap between all the levels is because so that first level, second level, third level, all are important in their own respective ways. Okay. So, and you get the attunement at each level. So when you get the attunement at each level, your shift of energies happen. Okay. In your life. So when this shift happens, you should be able to cope up with that shift. So that is why we keep a gap between the levels. The third level is the first is a master healer level. Okay. So where you're taught a master symbol. So when you are attuned to that master symbol, a flow of energies again comes to you. So you have to first, your energy levels and that flow has to be in balance, in sync with each other. So that is why we keep a gap of the fourth, third and the fourth also. The fourth level is a master teacher level where you're taught how you can attune the Reiki first level students and Reiki level 2.
Yeah.
So that's a big difference between the third and the fourth level. Okay.
Yeah,
from fourth level, you become a teacher.
Teacher.
Yeah. So that is why there is a gap between third and fourth also.
Okay. Thank you, Arpita.
Yes. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Arpita. You've been answering questions so patiently.
Yes.
So we have asked people, if anybody has any more questions, you can raise your hand. Arpita, I generally wanted to ask you, like,
yes,
I think this has come up yesterday also, and we've been getting this question on the groups also.
Yeah.
How long does it take for a Reiki session to work? Like, for example, there is pain or something and somebody comes to you for a Reiki session.
Yes.
How long does it take for the effect to show?
Reiki works in different ways for different person. Okay, so it depends on the person, individual to individual. Pain, if you're asking about the pain, it works effectively on pain within some time itself, I should say. If you're healing, whether distantly or whether in physical, that pain goes off in a few minutes, I should say. Again, it depends on person to person. That person should be, you know, in full acceptance of that Reiki. And yes, in full acceptance of that Reiki, that, you know, so that that person receives energy, Reiki energy very smoothly. Okay, so that is one thing also. And it depends on what kind of pain you're having, what kind of physical condition you are in. So it depends on that also. But Reiki, just a few sessions of Reiki, if you're working on a physical disease or a physical symptom of a disease, then it takes a few sessions, might be 2-3 sessions. If it's a critical disease or which has its roots a long way back, then it takes a long more sessions, lot of more sessions also. Depends on person, as I said, that person should be in full acceptance of Reiki. So depending on each, every individual, Reiki works accordingly, yes.
Thank you so much for that.
Thank you.
Arpita, Shweta is asking,
yes,
once attunement is done, if yes, we stop practicing, do we need to do attunement again?
Shweta, not necessary that you have to do the attunement again. As it is said that once you are attuned for a lifetime. But you need to start practicing the Reiki the same way as you did before, so that you can get back to your Reiki level.
Okay. All right. Samina is asking, she wants to know, if we have to do a 21-day practice after being attuned to level 1, and only then will we be taught level 2 after that?
Yes. First, you will be attuned to level 1, and there will be the learning of Reiki level 1. After that, only Reiki level 2 will be taught. That is okay. After, I think, 4-5 days, I'll keep a gap, and then I'll start with Reiki level 2. Not the 21 days, I won't keep a gap. But I would keep a gap of 4-5 days or a week or something. And then I'll be starting the Reiki level 2. But you have to continue the practice of the 21 days.
Mm, that's nice.
Yeah.
So one doesn't have to wait for level 2.
Yeah.
Not much.
Yeah.
So Galaxy is asking, once Reiki passed continuously to a person distantly, and when asked if there is no improvement, what does it infer? And what changes are required for improvement?
You have to at least, I would say, consult the client whom you're giving Reiki. What is his actual problem? Is he not open to Reiki? Or why is he not being, why Reiki is not showing any improvement? 110% Reiki shows effect or improvement, but if there is something the client which is holding back, which is not in full acceptance of the Reiki, then Reiki takes a longer time. But I think you need to consult that client, consult your client whom you're giving Reiki healing, that what is this from, need to talk about openly, so that, and you need to openly discuss about Reiki to them, so that they can understand in a better way. Their belief should be there in Reiki. If I'm taking a medicine and I do believe that no, this medicine is not going to work on me, it doesn't work in that way. It won't work even if it is from a qualified, very, very qualified doctor. So it is the same thing with Reiki also. Might be the person who is receiving the healing energy doesn't show any lack, have that lack of faith in Reiki, or doesn't have that strong receptance of Reiki.
Right. Arpita, we have got a question. How is Kundalini Reiki different from the regular Reiki?
Kundalini Reiki is different from regular Reiki, because Reiki is its traditional form. As I told you, Dr. Usui's I'm following, and Kundalini Reiki is a branch of this traditional Reiki. Now there have been many branches of Reiki, as you said, Kundalini Reiki. It is a completely different kind of Reiki. I cannot say further about it, but it is completely different from what you are going to learn. What is a traditional Reiki and this, both are completely different.
Right. Samina is asking, I'll just simplify her question. So Arpita, do we learn symbols in level 1?
This level 1 is only with your hands.
Right,
okay?
Right.
It's hands-on healing. Level 2, from level 2, you start learning symbols.
Right, and level 1 is touch healing. You have to be there in person. And
yes,
level 2, you can start doing distance healing, right?
Yes, right,
yeah,
exactly.
That's great. All right. So we'll just take on a couple of more questions if anybody has any.
Yes.
So we'll just wait for that. In the meanwhile, Arpita, Yeah. Do you want to tell us about your offer, if people can still go for it, or what is it?
Yes, as I had told yesterday on the call, that offer is still open. I'm keeping it open the same way it is open. That is, there are this offer is open today. The first 10 participants gets the lowest offer, that is 1,200 for Reiki level 1, where the actual price is 18,000. You're getting it for 1,200. So I hope, guys, you take this offer, take this opportunity. And what more is that I'm offering the bonuses offers also, along with the Reiki healing, Reiki courses. That is, you get the bonus offers of 10 healing, 10 individual, mark this, it is a 10 individual healing sessions, which you will be getting. Now, to even yesterday, I had this question, so I would clear on that also first. Healing session, in that sense, individual healing sessions means you can either take it for yourself or for your family member also. You can split the 10 sessions between you and your family member. So it depends on you, how you want to take. You can take only maximum 2 numbers. I would take 2 persons for the healing. So that is 10 healing individual sessions, which I'll be offering. Okay, that is one bonus offer. Then the other bonus offer is I would be giving 3 angelic messages monthly. So every month you will get an angelic message from me, which will be a very, you know, a true guidance for you for the whole month. And plus, I'll be offering, of course, a lifetime support, which is really priceless, which is really priceless. I'll be offering a lifetime support. You can connect with me anytime, whenever, in any practice of Reiki, whether you have healing somebody or you have any doubts or queries about Reiki, you can connect with me. And that is for a whole lifetime. So the Reiki level 1 right now, listeners, please enroll. There's 1,200 only with the bonus offers. And Reiki level 2 is 3,000 with the same bonus offers I'm going. And if you're taking Reiki level 1 and Reiki level 2 together, believe me, it is 3,000 only with all the bonus offers. So I would suggest, please take this offers, this opportunity I'm giving. I have never given such an opportunity, such offers before. I'm offering this because I'm very delighted to teach Reiki and to spread the knowledge of Reiki. So guys, please take this offer, this wonderful opportunity. Don't miss it.
Seriously, Arpita, it's really amazing. Yes. And I mean, how nice of you that we can split the 10 individual sessions with our family or loved ones. That's really generous. Yes. Really amazing, Arpita. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thanks a lot.
And also thank you for extending the offers.
Yes.
We really hope people go for it.
Yes.
And I'm just going to tell the dates. Please correct me if there are any changes, because some people are asking for the dates and timings.
Okay.
So level 1, you're planning to start on 25th July, right? Oh, sorry, 25th June.
Yes.
And it's going to be one call, either on Google Duos or Skype.
Yes.
It's going to be only one call, right? And then you're going to do the learning on WhatsApp for 3 days, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly.
Right. And level 2, it's the same. It's going to start on 2nd July.
Yes.
One online call and followed by 3 days of learning on WhatsApp.
Yes, exactly.
Right. And the call is going to be at 11 a.m.
I have put as 11 a.m. See, what I'll be doing is I can form a WhatsApp group. Those who are interested, I can send you the link, so that if anybody is having problem with the dates or with the time, you know, we can sort it out. Because since I put 11 o'clock, I think many people are not convenient with this time. So I can shift or I can change the timing accordingly, which suits everybody. So I think for that, I need to, communicate with everybody. I can form a subgroup for that. So, you know, mutually everything can be decided, whether this time and the dates, of course, those people who are not convenient with the dates also, I would give you other dates. So I think I can form a WhatsApp group where you all can join in to, you know, converse about the date and the timing.
How thoughtful, Arpita.
Yeah.
Thank you for that.
Yes.
So we'll just end with a few more questions.
Okay.
If you don't mind.
Yeah, of course, sure.
Jaya is asking the call, Arpita. How, yes. How long will be the call?
It will be around 2 to 3 hours.
Okay, great. All right. We'll just take a couple of more questions.
Yes.
What is going to be the duration of each bonus healing session?
Duration of each bonus healing
session? Yeah, the 10 individual healing sessions.
The duration, I would be connecting to individual persons also, those who are asking for the healing sessions, because I should know what healing I'm going to give for what purpose. So again, it depends on person, and I would suggest that I'm giving this healing session, but basically it is like I'll be connecting to that person and, you know, working on the issues of that person. So again, the duration will be different for all. But this 10 healing sessions would be given after that. If you require the healing sessions, if it is necessary, if it is felt necessary, of course, then I would be, of course, then it would be paid. But 10 healing sessions will be accordingly, I'll be talking to each and every person and then giving the healing sessions accordingly.
Great. That sounds good.
Yeah.
Arpita, Kavita is saying she has a request.
Yes.
She's made the payment for Reiki level 2 as okay. She has done Reiki level 1, but she's requesting if it is possible to put her for both level 1s and level 1 and level 2 as she's not practicing level 1. Would that be possible?
Yes, of course. I think you can go for Reiki level 1 and level 2. I think that would be better. If you're, you know, lost that practice, if you feel like restarting it, of course, it's a one good thing what you're doing. So I wouldn't say you know. Of course, you can go like that. Great. Start from Reiki level 1.
Wonderful. We'll just take a last question.
Yes.
Galaxy is saying,
yeah.
After passing healing, if there is not much change in my pains or concerns, what yeah. would you like to advise?
I would like to again say the same thing. Keep on doing Reiki. Because might be there are a lot of other things which Reiki is working on for you, because of which the pain is not reducing. So give Reiki a chance. Do Reiki regularly and properly might be. You would 100% receive the change. You would get that change. The pain would really at least minimize. See that the pain also minimize. Observe how you're feeling when you're giving Reiki. Observe what you're feeling when you're giving Reiki. And keep continue with Reiki. Reiki will work wonders. 110%. It will reduce your pain.
Wonderful. It's a wonderful note to end on, Arpita.
Yes.
Thank you so much for your time, for coming on again and answering us so patiently. Each yes. and every single detail, each and every single question. Thanks a lot.
Thanks a lot. And to all the listeners also, I'll be posting the WhatsApp group link. I think I can post in the groups. You would get the link from there. You can join the group and, you know, we can discuss about the date and the timing, because that's a question which I've been facing from yesterday.
Right.
Please check in the groups. You can receive that link from there.
Great. So thanks, Arpita. Thank you everyone for joining in.
Yeah.
As Arpita just said a few minutes ago, her offers are still on for a limited period.
Yes.
Level 1 for 1,200, level 1 and 2 for 3,000. Sorry, level 1 for 1,200, level 1 and 2 for 3,000.
Yes.
So go for it, guys. And yes, this is going to be a last call, but there is one big surprise for all of us tomorrow. So watch out for that on the groups. And people are thanking you, Arpita.
Yeah, thank you all. Thank you all so much for your questions. You know, your questions even are very important as you get to know more. And even I feel more connected with you all. So thank you for giving me this opportunity to explaining, you know, in everything in detail also. So thanks a lot for you all also. Thank you for being here, for listening to me.
Thanks, Arpita. Arpita, I just want to remind you one thing.
Yes.
You were talking about the WhatsApp group, right?
Yes.
You just create that, you know, our suggestion is just creating that for the people who have bought the packages, you know, so that you can coordinate with them.
Okay, okay.
You know, so you can probably send the link to people who have already enrolled and not put it up on the common groups, you know, otherwise it will create some confusion. And we can send it in the welcome email, you know, your link, the WhatsApp group link.
Okay.
You can send that in the welcome email.
In the welcome link, in the sense?
So we can talk about this later. We'll be sending a welcome email to people who have enrolled, right?
Okay, I got it.
You can share the link, telling people that, you know, we can discuss the timings on this group.
Yes, 100%. Yeah. Sure. I got it.
Because if you post it on the groups,
then it will be a lot of confusion.
Exactly. Possibly.
Yes. No problem, dear.
Okay, thanks, Arpita.
Thank you. Thanks, all of you.
Thank you so much.
Thanks,
everybody, for joining in.
Thank you.
Have a great day and look forward to tomorrow, all of us.
Yes. Thank you.
Thanks, Arpita. Thanks a lot.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.
Everyone. Bye.